Hello! Did you know that satoshis and yoctoNEAR are descendants of the very same logic that once pushed people to mint tiny copper coins? In this episode of Lantstorial, we'll explain how humanity moved from barter to cryptocurrencies, why yoctoNEAR and NEAR exist, and how they relate to the USD and the cent. Let's go! At first, people didn't have money in our modern sense. Within a tribe, game and supplies were divided by custom, depending on status, kinship, or community rules. But when surpluses appeared and people began trading with other groups, barter emerged. Direct exchange of goods. For example, Alice has 10 loaves of bread, but no fish. Bob has 3 fish, but no bread. They agree. Bob gives 1 fish to Alice and receives 2 loaves in return. It seems convenient. But this system had serious drawbacks. If Alice already has fish for several days, Bob won't find an interested partner in her. If Alice doesn't need fish at all, Bob will have to look for someone else with goods that interest Alice. Many products spoil quickly. Fish or bread won't keep for long. So people gradually began choosing a universal commodity for exchange. This could be salt, furs, cacao beans, or cowrie shells. These were valued by everyone, compact, and fairly durable. Eventually, metals became the main equivalent: bronze, silver, and gold. They were more convenient than other goods because they didn't spoil and took up little space. However, simple exchange of metals had a problem. Each time they had to be weighed and checked for purity. This took time and created room for fraud. To solve this, people invented coins. These were no longer just pieces of metal, but standardized discs stamped by the state, which guaranteed their weight and quality. Coins greatly simplified trade, since now it was enough to count them. But even with coins, difficulties remained. Imagine they were all made of a single metal. If it's copper, then to buy a horse or a house, you would have to haul a heavy bag of small change. If it's gold, you couldn't buy a fish or a loaf of bread. The coin itself would be too valuable. Cutting it up is also a problem. Pieces of different weights without a mint mark are easier to counterfeit. So states began minting different denominations from different metals: gold for large transactions, silver for medium ones, and copper or bronze for small market purchases. Such systems had fixed ratios. In medieval England, 1 pound equaled 20 shillings, and 1 shilling equaled 12 pence. Similar systems existed in other countries, but they differed from one another, which complicated calculations. The situation changed at the end of the 18th century. In 1792, the United States passed the Coinage Act, which introduced the dollar as the basic monetary unit and established a simple decimal system. $1 equals 100 cents. France made a similar move in 1795 after the Revolution, also switching to a decimal system. This proved extremely convenient. And during the 19th to 20th centuries, the decimal system spread almost worldwide. When the first digital money appeared, the question arose: store dollars and cents, or switch to fractional dollar values? However, due to computational limitations, for example, in the IEEE 754 standard, on which JavaScript, Python, and other languages are based, the operation 0.1 plus 0.2 equals 0.3, 15 zeros, 4. It became clear that fractions aren't suitable for precise financial calculations. Therefore, financial systems began storing amounts in whole minimal units, for example, in cents, and, for user convenience, displaying them as dollars and cents. After all, it's much easier to read 1,015.25 USD than 1,152.5 cents. When Bitcoin appeared in 2009, it continued this logic. For users, the main unit was 1 BTC, but at the protocol level, all calculations happen exclusively in satoshis, the minimal units. One Bitcoin was defined as 100 million satoshis, which is much finer than the 1 to 100 division of modern fiat currencies. Such high divisibility has several reasons. Satoshis are convenient for fees and micropayments, and limited issuance, a maximum of 21 million BTC, means that even at very high prices, Bitcoin remains usable for daily transactions. Other blockchains went even further. If one BTC equals 100 million Satoshis, then one ETH consists of 10 to the power of 18 Wei, and in the NEAR protocol, the native token NEAR is even more divisible, 10 to the 24th power yoctoNEAR, that is, one NEAR equals one quintillion yoctoNEAR. At the protocol level, all operations happen in yoctoNEAR. So all RPC calls, for example, to get an account balance, return values in minimal units. For people, these are displayed in NEAR in various apps. That's exactly why we created the Unit Converter, an instrument that lets you convert yoctoNEAR, or other minimal units, into human, near, and back, simply by specifying the number of decimal places for a given token. This makes working with cryptocurrencies much clearer. Did you enjoy the video? Subscribe to the channel, hit like, and keep building.